हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम यू ऑल इन टुडेज माय क्लास। इन टुडेज क्लास वी विल स्टडी टॉपिक अबाउट द मेकिंग ऑफ जर्मनी एंड इटली, एंड दिस टॉपिक इज फोर्थ पार्ट ऑफ योर हिस्ट्री चैप्टर 1। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट दिस वीडियो विद दिस टॉपिक। सो फर्स्ट वी विल स्टडी टॉपिक यूनिफिकेशन ऑफ जर्मनी। सो After ...1848, the conservatives started to use nationalism as a weapon to further their policies. This is clearly visible in how Germany and Italy united as nation-state. In Germany, nationalist feelings were widespread among middle class, who in 1848 tried to unite the different regions of the Germany Confederation into a nation state governed by an elected parliament. These efforts were suppressed by the monarchy and military and the landowners in Prussia. The national unification was taken under by the leadership of Prussia. Otto Bismarck of Prussia played the role of a main leader in act of nation building. So I also explained, after 1848, nationalism in Europe moved away from its association with democracy and revolution. Nationalist sentiments were often mobilized by conservatives for promoting state power and achieving political domination over Europe. This can be observed in the process by which Germany and Italy came to be unified as nation-state. As you have seen, nationalist feelings were widespread among middle-class Germans who in 1848 tried to unite the different regions of the German Confederation into a nation-state governed by an elected parliament. This liberal initiative to nation building was, however, repressed by the combined forces of the monarchy and the military, supported by the large landowners who called Junkers of Prussia. From then on, Prussia took on the leadership of the movement for national unification. Its chief minister, Otto Bismarck, was the architect of this process, carried out with the help of the Prussian army and bureaucracy. The three wars over 7 years with Austria, Denmark, and France ended in Prussian victory and completed the process of unification in January 1871. Caesar William I was declared as the new emperor of a new empire, German Empire, in a ceremony held at Versailles. So the initiative to unify Prussia was taken by the army under the leadership of Otto Bismarck. Prussia was united, asking the help from the army and bureaucracy. The unification of Germany established Prussian dominance in Europe. Currency, banking, legal and judicial system were introduced by the new German Empire. I hope you understood unification of Germany. Next, we will study topic about unification of Italy. During the middle of the 19th century, Italy was divided into 7 states, out of which only one state, Sardinia Piedmont, was ruled by an Italian princely house. All other regions were dominated by different kings. So, like Germany, Italy too had a long history of political fragmentation. Italians were scattered over several dynastic states as well as the multinational Habsburg Empire. During the middle of the 19th century, Italy was divided into seven states, of which only one, Sardinia Piedmont, was ruled by an Italian princely house. The north was under Austrian Habsburg, the center was ruled by the Pope, and the southern region were under the domination of the Bourbon King of Spain. Even the Italian language had not acquired one common form and still had many regional and local variations. So Italy was divided into seven states, of which only Sardinia Piedmont was ruled by an Italian princely state. Initially, the unification program was initiated by Giuseppe Mazzini, but it failed. Chief Minister Cavour led the movement with the help of Giuseppe Garibaldi. In 1861, Victor Emmanuel II was proclaimed King of United Italy. So during the 1830s, Giuseppe Mazzini had sought to put together a Croatian program for a unitary Italian Republic. He had also formed a secret society called Young Italy for the dissemination of his goals. The failure of revolutionary uprising both in 1831 and 1848 meant that he fell on Sardinia Piedmont under its ruler King Victor Emmanuel II to unify the Italian states through war. In the eyes of the ruling elites of this region, a unified Italy offered them the possibility of economic development and political dominance. So, Chief Minister Cavour, who led the movement of unify the regions of Italy, was neither a revolutionary nor a democrat. Like many others wealthy and educated members of the Italian elite, he spoke French much better than he did Italian. Through a tractful diplomatic alliance with France, engineered by Cavour, Sardinia Piedmont succeeded in defeating the Austrian forces in 1859. Apart from regular troops, a large number of armed volunteers under the leadership of Giuseppe Garibaldi joined the fray. In 1860, they marched into South Italy and the Kingdom of the Two Sicilies and succeeded in winning the support of the local peasants in order to drive out of Spanish rulers. In 1861, Victor Emmanuel II was proclaimed King of United Italy. However, much of Italian population, among whose rates of literacy were very high, remained blissfully unaware of liberal nationalist ideology. The peasants masses who had supported Garibaldi in southern Italy had never heard of Italia and believed that La Italia was Victor Emmanuel's wife. So some famous personalities who gave contribution of Italy unified, they are: first, Giuseppe Mazzini, who formed a secret society called Young Italy and also Young Europe in Brenne. Metternich described him as the most dangerous enemy of our social order. Second, फेमस पर्सनालिटी कॉन्ट कैमिलो डी कैवियोर, द चीफ मिनिस्टर ऑफ सार्डिनिया पिडमोंट, एंड थर्ड वाज जीसीपी गैरिबाल्डी. ओके, सो आई होप यू ऑल अंडरस्टूड इटली यूनिफाइड. नेक्स्ट वी विल स्टडी द ग्रोथ ऑफ ग्रेट ब्रिटेन. सो पीरियड टू द 18th सेंचुरी देयर वाज नो ब्रिटेन नेशन. द नेशन बिकेम पावरफुल एज इट सिटली ग्रीव इन वेल्थ इम्पोर्टेंस एंड पावर. सो द स्ट्रेंज केस ऑफ ब्रिटेन अबाउट द मॉडल ऑफ द नेशन और द नेशन स्टेट सम स्कॉलर्स हैव आर्ग्यूड इज ग्रेट ब्रिटेन. इन ब्रिटेन द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द नेशन स्टेट वॉज नॉट द रिजल्ट ऑफ अ सडन अफेवल और रेवोल्यूशन. सो द एक्ट ऑफ यूनियन 1707 बिटवीन इंग्लैंड एंड स्कॉटलैंड रिजल्टेड इन द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द यूनाइटेड किंगडम ऑफ ग्रेट ब्रिटेन. इट मीन्स इन इफेक्ट दैट इंग्लैंड वॉज एबल टू इम्पोज इट्स इन्फ्लुएंस ऑन स्कॉटलैंड. सो इट वॉज द रिजल्ट ऑफ द लॉन्ग ड्रॉन आउट प्रोसेस. देयर वॉज नो ब्रिटेन नेशन पीरियड टू द 18th सेंचुरी. द प्राइमरी आइडेंटिटीज ऑफ द पीपल हु इनहेबिटेड इन द ब्रिटेन इसलेस वर एथनिक मीन्स रिलेटेड टू अ कॉमन रेडिकल ट्राइबल और कल्चरल ऑरिजिन और बैकग्राउंड दैट अ कम्युनिटी आइडेंटिफाइज विथ और क्लान. सो एथनिक वंस सच एज इंग्लिश वेल्स स्कॉट और आयरिश ऑल ऑफ दिस एथनिक ग्रुप्स हैड देयर ओन कल्चर एंड पॉलिटिकल ट्रेडिशंस बट अस द इंग्लिश नेशन स्टेटली ग्रीव इन वेल्थ इम्पोर्टेंस एंड पावर. इट वॉज एबल टू एक्सटेंड इट्स इन्फ्लुएंस ओवर द अदर नेशंस ऑफ द आईलैंड्स. द इंग्लिश पार्लियामेंट विच हैड सीज्ड पावर फ्रॉम द मोनार्की इन 1688 एट द एंड ऑफ अ प्रोटेक्टेड कॉन्फ्लिक्ट वॉज इंस्ट्रूमेंट थ्रू विच अ नेशन स्टेट विथ इंग्लैंड अस इट्स सेंटर केम टू बी फॉर्म्ड. द एक्ट ऑफ यूनियन 1707 between England and Scotland that resulted in the formation of the United Kingdom of Great Britain meant in effect that England was able to impose its influence on Scotland. The Britain Parliament was henceforth dominated by its English members. The growth of a British identity meant that Scotland's distinctive culture and political institutions were systematically suppressed. The Catholic clans that inhabited the Scottish Highlands suffered tribal repression whenever they attempted to assert their independence. The Scottish Highlanders were forbidden to speak their Gaelic language or wear their national dress, and large number were forcibly driven out of their homelands. In 1801, Ireland was forcibly incorporated into the United Kingdom. A new British nation was formed. The symbol of New Britain were British flag like Union Jack and the national anthem God Save Our Noble King and the English language. So here your topic, the growth of Great Britain, is completed. I hope you understood. Next topic, we will study visualizing the nation. So in the 18th and 19th centuries, artists represented a country as a person and nations as female figures. During the French Revolution, female figures portray ideas such as liberty, justice, and the republic. Liberty is represented as a red cap or the broken chain. Visualizing the nation, meaning the nationalism was depicted by various personifications now as allegory. Allegory means when an abstract idea, just like for instance greed, anyway, freedom, liberty, is expressed through a person or a thing. An allegorical story has two meanings, one literal and one symbolic. So Germania and Marian were two famous allegorical figures. So here visualizing the nation is topic explanation completed. I hope you understood. Next topic, nationalism and imperialism. Last quarter of the 19th century, nationalism became a narrow creed with limited ends. Intolerance, Balkan became the sense of big power rivalry, nationalism, elegant with imperialism, case of World War First. Idea of a nationalism was now same everywhere, but concept of national state was accepted universally. So students, here your chapter 1 completed. I hope you understood all topics. Thank you for watching.